Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. All praises due to Allah, the Almighty, the Lord of the worlds. May Allah's peace, mercy, and blessings be upon His final and last messenger, Muhammad. And may Allah's peace, mercy, and blessings be upon each and every one of you, dear viewers, watching this episode of your program, The Revelation. With the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this episode, we are still continuing discussing and exploring the rulings of Zakat al-Fitr.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Innama as-sadaqatu lil-fuqara'i wal-masakini wal-'amilina 'alayha wal-mu'allafati qulubuhum والعاملين عليها والمؤلفة قلوبهم وفي الرقاب والغارمين وفي سبيل الله وابن السبيل فريضة من الله والله عليم حكيم.
In the name of Allah, the Merciful, the Compassionate.
Most surely, alms are for the poor, the needy, for those employed to administer it, for those whose hearts have newly embraced Islam, the ransoming of slaves, those in debt, in the cause of God, and for the wayfarer, an obligation from God, and God is all-knowing, all-wise.
Two questions that we have raised since the previous episode, and that's, is it permissible to give the obligatory charity for a charitable organization that can give it on my behalf? And of course, we said, yes, it is permissible, given the two important points that we have also highlighted. The second of the questions that, or the two questions that you have raised in the previous time was, is it permissible to give the obligatory charity to more than one individual, or it has to be given to only one person? And to answer this question, both are permissible. And the criterion is the benefit or the interest of the needy individual or individuals. So we need to make sure that when we give this obligatory charity, we are fulfilling the purpose of providing the charity, and that's by enriching this person. So for instance, if we know that by giving a portion of this obligatory charity of breaking the fasting, one individual who is a needy person and one who is a rightful recipient of Zakat al-Fitr, in this case, he will be in no need of more. Then in this case, we can look for others who are in need of this obligatory charity. So again, yes, it can be to one individual or more than one individual, depending on the benefit of the needy and the poor. With that being said, my dear viewers, we need to move on to talk about a very important question when it comes to the obligatory charity of breaking the fasting. And that's, what is the ruling on the person who does not give out or who does not pay and provide Zakat al-Fitr? Zakat al-Fitr, that it is an obligatory charity. So the one who does not pay it and give it out for no excuse is definitely a sinful person and needs to repent and to give the charity, the obligatory charity, to its due recipients. And this is the case also for previous years. So if there is one person, for example, who was in a position to offer Zakat al-Fitr. But for one reason or another, which is not a valid excuse, they did not, let's for example say that they didn't know that they have to. So in this case, they also need to make up for the previous years and they give this obligatory charity. And the evil, if this person has passed away, this obligatory charity of breaking the fasting is due from the estate or from the money or the wealth that he or she has left behind, as long as they were in a position when they were alive to give the obligatory charity of breaking the fasting. Because, like I said, it is an obligatory charity. Now, there is a very important question that we always hear and receive when it comes to charity and obligatory charity during the month of Ramadan. Many of us send asking the question of, I know that giving charity during the month of Ramadan is very blessed and is more likely to earn more rewards. So can I give my obligatory charity on wealth during the month of Ramadan, or what is the ruling in this case? And here, to clarify this point, because indeed it's a very common question, we need to understand a number of points. The first of them, when it is time to pay the obligatory charity, whether it's on wealth or real estates or livestock or any other obligatory charity, of course, this is other than the obligatory charity of breaking the fasting. This is other than Zakat al-Fitr, because when it comes to Zakat, we have broadly two categories. The first of Zakat al-Abdan, and this is in the form of Zakat al-Fitr, which has to do with the physical body of the individual. And we have Zakat al-Amwal, which is the obligatory charity that is given out when it comes to or as far as one's wealth is concerned. So when it comes to this category of Zakat al-Amwal or the wealth-related obligatory charity, there are a number of points that we need to observe. The first of them, it is very important to hasten towards giving out the obligatory charity when its time is due, and that's with the completion of al-hawl, or the completion of one entire lunar year. And the reason why it's very important to hasten towards fulfilling this obligation by the completion of one lunar month, or when it comes to the charity of crops, with the harvest of the crops, because the Quran clearly states, سارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم. That's hasten towards forgiveness from your Lord. And we all know the verse.
In the name of Allah, the Merciful, the Compassionate.
Vie with one another towards forgiveness from your Lord, and a garden whose width is the width of heaven and earth, prepared for those who believe in God and His messengers. That is the bounty of God. He bestows it upon whoever He pleases, and God is of bounty abounding.
It is very important for the Muslim, when the time of the charity is due, to hasten towards fulfilling this pillar of Islam and this obligation, lest any calamity would or any problem would arise and this would prevent him or her from fulfilling this obligatory charity. Another thing, my dear viewers, here to be noted is that the person becomes sinful and blameworthy if they delay giving the obligatory charity for no excuse. So if you have no excuse to delay giving out your obligatory charity, then in this case you have to hasten towards fulfilling this obligation. Number three, my dear viewers, is a very important thing, and that's, it is okay to give zakat al-amwal or the obligatory charity ahead of its due time, after its time is due. So for instance, let's say that the time with which giving my obligatory charity is in Sha'ban or during the month of Sha'ban. Then in this case, I have no excuse to delay it. But on the other hand, when it comes to the month of Ramadan, then in this case, it is okay for me, and it is important, as a matter of fact, to hasten towards giving the obligatory charity during the month of Ramadan and not to delay it. And also, to complete the set of the examples in this regard, it is also okay if my time or if the due time for giving my obligatory charity is in the month of Shawwal, and now it is the month of Ramadan, then in this case, it is permissible to give the charity, the obligatory charity, ahead of the month of Sha'ban, because it is the month of Ramadan, and it is more rewarding, and to seize the opportunity of the blessed month of Ramadan. So, like I said, it is okay to give it ahead of its time. And we learn this from the haditha or from the event of Al-Abbas, the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as he asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam if he can give the obligatory charity ahead of its due time. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam agreed and approved this, and he also showed us that it is permissible to give zakat al-fitr ahead of its due time up to 2 years. So up to 2 years ahead, we can give the obligatory charity on our wealth. That's it for this episode. As always, your questions and your feedback and your suggestions are most welcome and are most valued. To receive them via our Facebook page, which you can see now on the screen. And of course, you can watch this episode and the previous ones on the same page and the rest of the social media. That's it for this episode. I leave you in the care of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wishing you all the best. Until then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.